So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs, where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news, which are relevant for all the government exams. Alright, so let's begin with the session without any delay. But before we begin, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed, and you can also ask your doubts here. You can also follow me on Instagram. This is my Instagram ID. Here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question, which is with respect to the Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Ann Yojana. So you have to consider the following statements with respect to the best performing states under Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Ann Yojana, and you have to identify the incorrect statement. So Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution has announced the list of best performing states under the Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Ann Yojana in phase 1, 2, 3 and 4. Phase 1, 2, 3 or 4 ke best performing states inhone bata diye hain, because phase 5 is currently going on. Phase 5 was started in the month of December 2021 and it will be continued till March 2022. Now what is this Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Ann Yojana, by the way? So it was launched in the year 2020 in the wake of COVID-19 pandemic to provide food grains, to provide absolutely free food grains to the NFSA beneficiary. And under this particular program, 5 kg per person per month is provided to the beneficiaries. All right, and it has the scheme has till now 5 phases, and the 5th phase, as I told you, was started in the month of December 2021 and it will be continued till March 2022. Now let's talk about the best performing states or UTs under Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Ann Yojana. So talking about phases 1 and 2, combined. So in the phases 1 and 2, both Meghalaya and Mizoram have achieved the 100% target under this particular scheme. So we can say Mizoram and Meghalaya are the top performing states in phases 1 and 2. This is for combined phase 1 and 2, do remember this. Arunachal Pradesh and Sikkim achieved the 99% target, while these six states and UTs achieved the 98% target under Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Ann Yojana. And these are Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Rajasthan, Jammu and Kashmir, Lakshadweep, Chhattisgarh and Nagaland. Now no need to remember all these, just remember the 100% and the 99%. 100% target achievers were Mizoram and Meghalaya, while 99% target achievers were Arunachal Pradesh and Sikkim. Now talking about phases 3 and 4, this is for phases 3 and 4 combined. So in phases 3 and 4, it is Chhattisgarh which is the best performing state, which has achieved 98% target under this particular Yojana, followed by Tripura, Mizoram and Delhi, West Bengal. Tripura, Mizoram, Delhi and West Bengal, which have achieved the 97% target under the Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Ann Yojana. So in this also, just remember the best performing state, that is Chhattisgarh, which is more than enough. Usse zyada aapko yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai. Now the best performing state in the intra-state portability. In the intra-state portability using one nation one ration card, ka use karte hue intrastate portability mein the best performing state, guys, in all the phases combined together is Bihar. Some char phases mila ke intrastate portability mein using one nation card, Bihar is the best performing state. While talking about the interstate portability ki hum baat kare using one nation one ration card, so it is Delhi which is the best performing state, or you can say the best performing UT among all the states and UTs across the country. Alright, and which reminds us, hame ye batata hai ki Delhi mein sabse zyada migrants the, and that's why interstate portability yahan pe itni zyada hai. So guys, itna hi hai isme. Now let's come back to the question. Then you have to identify the incorrect statement. Let me rub all these things first, otherwise khichdi na ban jaye. Alright, so you have to identify the incorrect statement. In first and second phases, both Mizoram and Meghalaya had achieved the 100% target. This is absolutely correct. In third phase, Chhattisgarh had achieved the 100% target. Chhattisgarh is the best performing state, but it had achieved 98% target, not 100%. So this is incorrect. In the category of interstate portability using one nation, one ration card, Bihar is the best performing state. Interstate portability mein Delhi is the best, while Bihar is the best in intrastate portability. Alright. So 2 and 3 must be the correct answer, option C. Alright, option C is the correct answer. Now moving ahead to question number 2. With which of the following universities, Investor Education and Protection Fund Authority has signed an MOU to achieve the mandate of investor education awareness and protection? So you, आपने ये पता नहीं इस अथॉरिटी का नाम सुना है या नहीं सुना है तो मैं आपको बता देता हूँ जल्दी से. So remember, this Investor Education and Protection Fund Authority was established in the year 2016 under the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, which is currently headed by Nirmala Sitharaman. Alright, and what was the objective of establishing this? The objective of establishing this authority is to provide investors the proper education, the proper awareness and the proper protection. Investors ke education ke liye, investor ke awareness ke liye aur investor ke protection ke liye this authority was established in the year 2016 under section 125, under section 125 of the Companies Act of 2013. Okay. Now this authority has signed an MOU to achieve this mandate of investor education, awareness and protection with which of the following universities? So remember, this is Indira Gandhi National Open University, IGNOU, jiske saath is organization ne, is authority ne MOU sign kiya hai. Now this MOU has been signed to achieve the mandate of investor education, awareness and protection, and it will be done. This mandate will be done. Basically, ये जो investor education, awareness और protection है, ये कैसे होगा? It will be done by utilizing the tele-lecturing facility of Gyan Darshan Channel. Gyan Darshan Channel का tele-lecturing facility का इस्तेमाल करते हुए lectures provide कराए जाएंगे to the investors ताकि उनको aware किया जा सके, ताकि उनकी protection की जा सके. And total 75 lectures will be live streamed on the channel. And of course, it is a part of भारत का आजादी का अमृत महोत्सव. आजादी का अमृत महोत्सव, दैट्स व्हाई दे आर टेकिंग 75 लेक्चर्स. ऑलराइट, सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर विल बी व्हाट गाइस? ऑप्शन डी, इग्नू. इंदिरा गांधी नेशनल ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, एंड इन द लास्ट क्वेश्चन डू रिमेंबर दैट द सेक्रेटरी इन द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कॉर्पोरेट अफेयर्स के जो सेक्रेटरी होते हैं, दैट इज द एक्स ऑफिशियो चेयरपर्सन ऑफ Investor Education and Protection Fund Authority. Okay. Now let's talk about question number 3. Consider the following statements with respect to Swachh Vidyalaya Puraskar 2021-22 and you have to identify the correct statement. Alright. So Swachh Vidyalaya Puraskar abhi diye nahi gaye hain, sirf announced hue hain. Theek hai, please remember this. So Ministry of Education has announced the Swachh Vidyalaya Puraskar 21-22. Now remember, the very first Swachh Vidyalaya Puraskar were given in the year 2016-17, and these awards will be given to those schools who lay emphasis on and have done exemplary work in the field of water, hygiene and sanitation. Do remember these three keywords: water, hygiene and sanitation. Alright, now remember, the awards are open to all the categories of schools, whether it is a government school, whether it is a government aided school or it is a private school, and in both urban and rural areas. There are 6 sub-categories on which the schools will be judged: water, sanitation, hand washing with soap, operation and maintenance, behavior change and capacity building, and the newly added COVID-19 preparedness and response. And remember, at the national level, 40 schools will be awarded under the overall category. So here in this particular question, you have to remember, देखो 3-4 चीजें सारी याद रख लेना, okay? Alright, so let's identify the correct statement then. It has been announced by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Nahi. It is by Ministry of Education headed by Dharmendra Pradhan. The awards will be given to only government and government aided schools. No, private schools are also, these awards are also open to the private schools. The first edition of this award was given in, not in 2014, it was in 2016-17 when the first edition of these awards were given. So all the statements are incorrect, which means option D, none is correct, guys, should be the correct answer. And let's move ahead to question number 4 then. Where has Prime Minister Modi inaugurated a technology center of Ministry of MSME, which will provide training to the youths. Around 20,000 trained youth will be provide training at this technology center. It will support MSMEs and startups. All right, and do remember, this was established, this was inaugurated at Puducherry, option E. Option E, Puducherry is the correct answer, and in this particular news, इसके अलावा और भी कुछ आपके लिए relevant नहीं है. Question number 5, which power PSU of India has signed a joint agreement with African Infrastructure Investment Platform, which is known as Africa 50, for development projects in Kenya. And this power PSU will provide technical support, in these development projects in Kenya. Remember, this is Power Grid Corporation of India Limited. Option C is the correct answer. And in this question also, इसके अलावा कुछ भी याद रखने की जरूरत नहीं है. Just remember, Power Grid has signed and this MOU with Africa 50, which is an African Infrastructure Investment Platform. Okay. Now, what is the purpose? For development projects in Kenya. Okay. So, option C is the correct answer. All right, guys. So, that's it for the session today. I hope all the 5 questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you on Monday in the next session. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.